This is a Cornell pump, the interchange with the Papco pump on a Nielsen fish pump. The modifications involved were quite extensive, both the mounts, bolts, flanges, to make this interchange with the Papco pump. Crew spent about 12 hours assembling. It's considerably bigger, the Papco pump, and we're going to take it from here to testing. We have out here today the president of Cornell's pump company and the president of Cascade Pump Company. Right now, we're giving a demonstration of what the modifications were when they put this together.
So, you know, that makes, you know, 6 volts.
This pump was taken off the original. It's a simpler design pump, but some of the features involved here compared to the Cornell pump is, as we get closer to it, I'll show you.
Look at this way.
The volute on this pump is a straight line, and what I'm going to point to it, it's in just a straight circle compared to the Cornell pump, which is offset volute. This might have been account for some of the losses we've had with this fish pump in the past. I'll point it out now. The Cornell pump takes advantage of the water being thrown to the outside. We'll look at that when it goes over there. As you can see, the volute is offset on this, and this takes advantage of the water itself. Unlike the Papco pump, which is bearings, well, a grease bearing, the Cornell pump is the oil bearings itself.
That's why I was thinking. Yeah, it's going to expand some. I didn't know if there's any seals in there that it's going to do anything.
Well, we're pumping from one side of the pond to another side of the pond with the Papco pump. We'll be repeating the same procedure on pond number 6 using the Cornell pump. What we're looking for is basically damage to the fish only.
see any looting, any pumping. These fish will be going through the canal pump. Pond 5 after the pumping.
You got that crank up, man. You got that crank up and go down. I was just asking if you had to go down. No, no, you don't.
Seems to be only 3 to 4 visible mortality after the pumping. Pond 5. Going into pond 6. Say it again. Pump current is 600 RPM. That's the final decision on the RPM of the pump, 600.
The Paco pump is, but it's obviously pumping fire doesn't have water.
Okay, the Cornell pump manufacturer says in industry they like to have a product ratio going through here in about 1 second per foot. Right now, if you kind of count it, if we're running at 500 RPM, we're running about 3 fish per second through a foot. So this is about what industry uses to pump their product. And that's about the efficiency of the pump right there. Some other thoughts they brought up here is going to electric pump, electric motor. You only need a 5-horse with a variable speed to dial in the RPM that we need to pump the most efficient on these fish. We're 200 RPMs less with this unit than with the Papco. Papco 700, we're down to about 500 right now with it. One of the things we've noticed is that with this unit, possibly we need design for a bigger dewatering box.
This is pond 6 after they've been moved through the canal pump. Both pond 5 and 6 had approximately 50,000 feet. Bond 6 has no mortality.
Don't you scaling?